Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mordheim, City of the Damned. Now, before I start the whole gameplay and the introduction of the game and all that, I'd like to go on record. I looked over my last video. I'm sorry for the lack of sound of things that you have to turn up the volume. I don't have that kind of money to do A-grade stuff, so please bear with me. I also noticed that my speech may be, you know, a little bit slurred and all that. My apologies. I'll be trying to speak a little bit slower and as more clearly as much as possible. But welcome back to Mordheim. Now, last game video, I promised that I would talk about the skill sets. And as you can see, my warband has definitely increased in size. But before I explain some of the newer classes, I'm going to explain skills real quick. Typically, skills fall under two categories: active skills and passive skills. Passive, you don't have to worry about them; they always apply into effect automatically. Active, you have to actively use them to make them in effect. Now, each character at least gets a passive skill, and each passive skill is unique according to character class and to the warband itself. Now, normally you get skills by leveling up your character, getting the experience bar at the upper left corner under the character's name to max, and normally you get two unspent skill points. Normally you get 4 to make mastery, but there are requirements as you can see on the bottom. Now, to get certain skills, typically you need to upgrade one of your 9 stats on your left right here. And that normally determines if you can actually get it. You have to wait, as well as if you have the skill points and the money to do it, as well as how long it's going to take. Each one of these categories reflects the certain level of attributes or skills that your character needs, or what you can expect. So, for example, from toughness, I can expect more skills that represent, you know, having a stronger health, easier recovery, or more resistance. While the weapon skill may be more reflection on defensive skills, it was repairing or attacking. Now, each warband has their own unique set of skills. Now, there should be 3 here, but I only got 2 of them: Archer of the Silent Death and Swarm. The same thing also applies with active skills. Even 3 unique warband specific active skills. Now, the reason I want to go through the skills first is because of this big guy. In the last video, I mentioned the impressive. Now, this isn't impressive. At least one of them. Now, I'm going to say on record, not all impressives are big hulking beasts like the rat ogre here. You know, I know that the Sisters of Sigmar was impressive. It looks like a normal human. But the one thing I want to go on record saying with impressives is that they're called out for a reason. High health, good critical compared to most others, nice damage, armor, natural armor absorption. Actually, I may want to double check on that one real quick. This impressive has a natural armor absorption. And you can see that on the left side, he can do some pretty good damage. Not range-wise, but either way. Each impressive comes with their own set of perks. Normally, I'll just state off their perks that you can expect for most, if not all, impressives. large, which the perk large makes him more resistance to stuff as poison, critical, and stun. Gives an armor absorption, but has decreased range resistance. It cannot use consumables or search and activate actions. Now, I'm not sure if this is true about the Sisters of Sigmar's. It's impressive. I have yet to play them. One thing I am certain about, even though I haven't played them all, is Last Stand. Pretty much, if an impressive gets into a fight, they fight to the death. So, be careful where you send them to fight and what to fight. Good if you want to slow down the enemy, block up a wet doorway, or even just get the other impressive into a fight. Again, be careful. Then there's Unwavering. One thing I expect from all impressives as well is that they're immune to all alone, fear, and terror tests. Meaning if the enemy is very scary or this oppressive gets ganged up by the entire warband, he will not stop fighting or run. And since they're all impressives, they're immune to the tiring effect. So that means I can still use my offensive points over here without having to worry about them. Without worrying about the attacks increasing cost. Sorry about that. But as you also see here about the last perk I'm about to mention, Stupidity, that's just for the Rat Ogre. When I did the Human Mercenaries impressive, which is just a normal ogre, he did not have Stupidity. But the Rat Ogre does. And normally, if you get this on a henchman, I recommend you just fire him. But I'm taking a risk here with this impressive. And pretty much, Stupidity on the start of this, as you can read here, he needs to make an intelligence check. And as you can see, it's not so good, but neither is it not so bad right now, to my opinion. And this only applies if he's not engaged. If he is engaged, I have nothing to worry about. Now, the reason I mentioned skills earlier is because luckily I could avoid or that stupidity as long as I have this Azen Sorcerer, mostly because of this ability Guidance, which prevents the need for intelligence check on that impressive as long as I use it on him. So that's the good thing. Now, before I go into the story mode, as you notice, my warband is different, better armor, better equipment. But since last then, I lost more leader characters and more hero characters than I did henchmen. I should be expected to lose more henchmen than heroes and leaders. So I suffered some bad luck. Hopefully I don't have that. If I do, my apologies if I start swearing and getting angry. This game, as I may have mentioned in the last video, is a love-hate relationship game. And again, sorry for pronunciation. I have a speech impediment, so my apologies. Now, as I mentioned, I am going to get into the story mode mission. Now, once I get into this, I'm going to explain how story missions are different from your normal campaign missions and all that. Yeah, you guys can read this on your own free time. I'm just going to skip through it.
A new round has started.
Well, I guess the game's gonna explain, but I'm also going to explain as well. Story missions, much different from campaign missions. What you can expect is the enemy warband would never rout. Morale has nothing to do with them. But morale still affects my warband. So, I gotta be careful, but I could kill them as much as I want. But the problem is, as I killed off the enemy, reinforcements will arrive. The good thing is, those reinforcements, from my experience with the human mercenaries campaign, they're weak and easy to deal with, if unless you have bad luck. The only way to beat a story mission is to complete the objectives. These objectives will change throughout the course of the mission, but not by much. The good thing is, though, early story missions to help deal with reinforcements and the enemies already there, I get to use a special, unique character that's only playable for story missions. And once I get to use him, which seems to be third on the initiative at 67, I'll explain how good they are. One thing is, I want to be victorious because, as it mentions as the last thing, any items gathered will be discarded if I'm not victorious. That's self-explanatory. Well, it seems like my objectives are locate barrels of blasting power and locate the human hideout. So it looks like we're blowing up humans. And as you can see on my map here, these two green circles, that's where I can expect to find the blasting powder and possibly the human hideout. Now, I'm still going to probably do some looting of these war zones and search points. And as you can see, the small glowing circles here, that's indication of the objectives. So you can see where the glowing circles are next to barrels on the map. So, I can use that to my advantage if I'm lost. And I'm going to be honest with you, I probably will get lost. The story missions normally take me a couple hours to complete them. Mostly because I'm going, where the hell are these last couple objectives that I need to get? But overall, I will probably try to do some looting, get some extra money. So, let's see where the enemy is. Let's see if I can avoid getting stabbed. So far, so good. Maybe am I even go? Oh, apparently I am going the right way. I'm just gonna make sure I cross that bridge. Yeah, it's probably gonna be slow here until something comes up. So once that does happen, then I'll just cut through until I get to it. But for now, just assume that there will be some cutting back and forth in the editing. So this is gonna be slow, and I'll probably come up with the failed a stupidity check. So he skips his turn. Luckily, I got guidance in this bugger here. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Well, this is my special character. The special, unique veteran I mentioned about. Now, he may not seem like much, but trust me. Just look at his stats at the bottom left corner. High damage. Pretty decent armor. Good critical. And has one advantage right now. Now, Normally, these veteran characters are worth keeping, but you also got to make sure you keep alive because they can do stuff like guidance. Not all of them, but this one has special abilities that other characters don't have. Guidance, which is kept with a rat ogre, but I'm going to have my sorcerer keep an eye on him. Warp poison. Not familiar with it, but if I'm correct, I get to poison groups of enemies or get to poison my weapons before combat. Also, they have a good or a defense. Now, the human veteran that I played with on the human campaign mercenaries had a better defense in this. So hopefully this guy has a better attack than he does defense, because I do not like that 70% of dodge. And it looks like the enemies gather around the blasting powder, so I'm going to be careful. And what I can gather, we got a warlock, a henchman, and a youngblood. The youngblood, I'm worried about the most. Henchman, second, unless the warlock has some good attack spells. If he does, then I may have a problem. But for now, I'm not so worried about it. But it doesn't seem like I can use my impressive right away to help get that blasting powder. Not unless I'm gonna go the long way around it. And I don't, and I have no idea what the hell is going on with that tower up there. No idea. Alright, well, I'm gonna go into the... I didn't chat anything.
A new round has started.
It looks like the young blood decided he wanted to come in and fight now. Yeah. My problem is that the one thing I hate about playing as the Skaven, from my experience so far, is that they have terrible range units. If anything, I would try and, if you want to go a range, go with one of the other factions so far. Because at best, Skaven can only use shurikens, what this guy has right now, or warp lock pistols. And they both do have a range of 15, so if I try to get any closer, hopefully this guy doesn't have Overwatch. Yep, he does. Luckily, archers don't do a lot of damage. Yeah, but in other words, play as another warband if you want good archers. Because Skaven, they're good with melee and surrounding your enemy, but they do not have good range weapons. I'll tell you that now. And normally don't do perception checks, but might as well. And trap down there. Some wonky, I think, barrels and something. I think that's another trap. And there's an arrow. Now, since I give the guidance to my... Since with the sorcerer, I gave guidance to the impressive. He is going to be effective now, at least as long as I keep the guidance up. But typically, the one thing I worry about impressives is that when you're deploying them in the battle, you want them to be not, you want them to be able to move, because the one time I used the human mercenaries impressive, the ogre, first battle I used him in, he was, the first battle I used him in, he was trapped in the house for the entire battle. So you gotta be careful because they cannot fit through doorways. Now it's time to see if the, let's see if warp port, yep, poison my weapons. And let's see if I can stab this warlock. Oh, wow. Oh my god. I'll tell you this now. When I play the human mercenaries veteran, he does not do damage like this. He has a good defense, but oh my god. This attack. Oh. Oh my god. If he can do damage like that, that's... Oh, I want to make sure I keep him around, but it's going to be hard doing so. Yeah, you just saw me use an active ability. I know it went by that fast, but normally active abilities can do stuff like, but that 95 chance to hit. Oh god, this is gonna be. Yeah, that should have been. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. If you have over a 90% chance, you should be able to hit the enemy without every single time, to my opinion. Luckily, he just got stunned. Now I know my game froze there for a second. Again, my apologies, that's my computer. But it only happens when I stun, or at least the first couple of stuns. But nothing you need to worry about now from that. Or at least not as bad. Unfortunately, stun only is really effective against henchmen, if you ask me. If not, then there's a chance that the special hero character may just recover and just do some damage. Now, you're wondering why I'm probably scooting in like this? Yep, I was trying to avoid the ambush. Depending on your enemy, you can oftentimes just avoid the ambush by just edging along. If not, then just hope you have a good melee and good natural melee resistance. Like I said, 95 chance to hit, it still misses. Let's see if we can crush. Oh, let's see if my impressive can crush some skulls. Oh, he's gonna be. Fuck you, game. Thank you, game. Like I said, they're impressive. Oh, if he didn't dodge the first time, that archer would have been dead. No doubt about it. Yeah, I may use the veteran just as a hit and run guy at this point. Because, oh god, the damage he's doing. This guy is definitely someone you want just hitting and running. The only problem is I probably gonna need to keep him away because his dodging is not that great. But this sorcerer, an impressive combo, is working out well. Now, I want to go on record and say this, that between the human mercenaries, warlock, and the Skaven's Essian sorcerer, I prefer the Skaven sorcerer. Mostly because his spells seem much more effective, or later on they will be. The warlock, his starting... Okay, before I say the warlock starting spell, the Skaven's sorcerer starting spell lowers the three stats of strength, toughness, and agility down. And that's a pretty good deal if you ask me. The warlocks, he uses a blinding light, so it makes it harder to hit. But the Skaven, but overall, when you level them up, the Skaven has better abilities that debuffs the enemy, to my opinion. So yeah, Skavens make great debuffers, to my opinion. Well, I just learned out the last of the blasting barrels I may need to grab are literally right at the enemy's camp. So, probably after I killed off these original mercenaries here, it should be fairly easy for me at that point. But for now, it's just the hope of make sure my war baron is still alive. And as you can see, I'm going to say this now. You just saw that guy Archer took a shot at me, literally with a gun. I got lucky, but fun fact about using archers and ranged units, if you have the chance, put them at higher ground, because higher ground, they gain bonuses to hit you. And I got lucky, so... This is now a game of dodge and weave and not get shot. Which may be harder than I thought. So, hopefully right here he has no good shot at me. Yeah, the bad thing about Precious is that they can't move around as easily. So, you gotta make sure you keep an eye out for passageways, or you may have to just wiggle your way around. And you can see there, doorway, he won't be fitting through that. I wish he could, the woman is so much greater, but at this point, it's just better to just send him around and hopefully he can just rip somebody's spine back there. What the hell? Oh, they do. Yeah, I'm going to say this now. If you heard me talking about the oppressors earlier, yeah, they have an ogre. And he may be trapped inside, and I hope not, because... Ooh, that's going to be a nightmare for me. See what I mean? Freaking ogre. It can't fit through the door, so that's still good for me. But bad overall, because I need to get in there eventually. And yeah, hopefully my rat ogre can get in on the other side. Ooh, I can tell that stance ain't wrong. He has a gun.
Objectives added. Objective completed.
Kill Volug Foot Stomper. And if I'm correct, that's the... Yep. I have to kill that ogre. Now at least I can play some of this.
Objectives updated.
Yep. Good news. Yeah, I'm going to tell you guys this now. I'm not going to send my captain to literally fight an ogre. At least not now. Not even my veteran at this point. Not unless I can get them gang up. Not unless I can gang up on the enemy. Oh, apparently guidance lasts multiple turns. That's a good thing. I thought I had to keep using guidance every turn. Now let's see if we can. Oof. Oh. Yeah, I can tell he's gonna get ambushed. Maybe I can just go around and try a different charge route. Yeah, when it comes to ambush attacks, the only counter to that is a charge. Time for a battle fight to the death. Ogre versus Rat Ogre. Who will win? So far, the ogre looks like it. But then again, we are rats, so we don't play fair to begin with. And I know this is against what I want to do, but let's be honest, that damage, how can I say no to it? If that, as long as that ogre can't get good dodges, this is gonna be easy. I'm not liking. Okay, a rat ogre comes through here and he doesn't get trapped, but my sorcerer, who's really smaller than him, gets hit with a trap. Well, I may not be able to provide guidance again, but the one thing I can do, debuff. Yeah, the strange thing about spells in this game is that apparently sometimes they work inside, sometimes they don't work outside, sometimes they just simply don't work. It doesn't tell you if it's failed or succeed, it just simply doesn't work for some reason. Don't know why, but it just happens. Whew. Okay, not bad. Keep calm, keep calm.
Objective.
You know, it's quite surprising how a rat this size can carry 2 barrels of that.
New round has
yep,
started.
Like I said, enemy reinforcements. Now, these guys should not be that much of a challenge. And hopefully they aren't. The real challenge are normally always the guys that are here first. But I went ahead and did a little cheating. Went straight through. The first time I did the first story mission, again, was with human mercenaries, and to be quite frank, I didn't have an impressive. Heck, I think I only had 2 hero types. And they were mostly useless. Rat Ogre wins! Woo!
Completed.
Now it's time to terrorize the rest of the neighborhood. Now the question is, where do those reinforcements come from? At least, where are they, to be honest? Yeah, I'm just gonna kill this archer real quick because he's archer, 2 hits, dead. God, this. Like I said, veterans are great, but you gotta be careful. No, we're not. Oh, found one of the reinforcements. Little bugger was trying to be sneaky. Well, time for a curse. Now, I do want to say one thing real quick about spellcasting, is that if you take a look here at the upper right, you see that potential Tezzeret curse. Yeah, anyone using spells, there's a possibility of that curse happening. And let me be honest, that curse begins as simple, some damage to. To debuffs, prevents you from with spells, to the point of even doing 9,999 damage. I said 9,999 damage. And this applies to all spellcasters, enemies and allies. So, pray to God that if you do get a debuff, that is minor, and you don't have to worry about it. But there are skills, as I mentioned with the skills, you can actually get some stuff that can actually prevents the curse, or at least reduce the chances of the curse happening. This game at times. Like I said, love-hate relationship. Luckily, these guys are normally, reinforcements are normally weak. Now, I'm going to go on record that if you get the chance in this game, loot the enemy's stuff. Because, as you can see here, they got some good stuff here. Some good war stones, some money. Unfortunately, I forgot this guy had some of the blasting powder. Honestly, I wish there was a way that you didn't have to keep track of, mentally keep track of who has what. Because I'm going to be honest with you, I have lost track more times than anything. And hopefully this character only has a crossbow. If he does, easy kill. And he does not.
Started.
Yeah, a reason this game. If someone's already engaged with the enemy, the chances to hit someone with a ranged weapon goes down. Makes sense when you think about it, but overall, one of those deals where you get the idea what I'm trying to say here. Well, Well, everyone, I'm going to place the last blasting powder. And it's probably been an hour or so, so time to end this mission. And as you can see, no one died, but I managed to kill 11 humans. Now I probably waited too long to make it really effective against me, but then again, last time I did it not going in. I wasn't expecting an oppressive to fight against an oppressive when I didn't have one. But now I know a little bit better, so I'm more prepared. But for now, let's see if I get some good stuff out of this.
You are progressing, nice.
Yeah, I'll let you guys read this on your own time.
Outstanding.
Well, that does it for this video of Mordheim, City of the Damned. We came out well. We got some good loot, even though the aftermath results didn't show it. We actually got a good haul of, well, mainly useless junk that we can sell, and a handful of ward stones. But overall, good mission, good story mission. Now, I will go on record to say that when I did the Human Mercenaries campaign mission, just the first one, I fought against the Skaven. It was the same concept, but instead I was blowing up the sewers, cutting off access to them. I'm not sure if these missions are just repeats of themselves, just of different perspectives and how things happen. But so far, that was the first story mission of Act 1, of Episode 1, or Chapter 1, or how you want to say it, of the Skaven. So, we murdered some humans, ripped off their arms with our impressive, and blow them up and talked about skills. I guess this is where I'm going to end my video for the day. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm going to just do another story mission for the next video, or just another normal campaign mission, just to see how much things change. I think I may just stick with story missions for this, and so just do a campaign mission between the acts. But until next time, don't panic. Chaos is at work. Oh, wrong thing.